Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I ask that you remain standing. Gentlemen, remove your hats as our colors are presented and the Star Spangled Banner is performed.
Thank you. You may be seated.
Good morning, graduates. I'm Joshua Hyde. It is an honor and a privilege to be in front of you this morning. First, I would like to thank my family, friends, teachers, and faculty that have supported me through school so I could be on this stage today. And secondly, I want to thank the student body for giving me the opportunity to speak on their behalf. Today is the culmination of many years of hard work for our class, and it was not the easiest journey. We had a relatively normal school life through elementary, middle, and our first year of high school, until the COVID pandemic hit. Our world was flipped upside down, and our lives completely changed, but we persevered amidst the life-altering event. We adapted to wearing masks, navigating online classes, attending Zooms, and adjusting to part-time in the school building. Even with all these obstacles in front of us, we did not lose sight of what was most important, our passions. The word passion has its roots in the Latin word passeo, which means to suffer or to be acted on. In the modern sense, we do not tend to think of passion as suffering, but we do view it as something worth suffering for. The journey from childhood to adulthood can make a profound impact on what we are passionate about. While we are growing up, passion begins to spark within us, and we start to understand what we love. We gain life lessons, explore new places, and meet new people. These events build character and shape who we are. This adds tinder to the spark, and passion becomes a flame. Eventually, our passions fan and blaze, so we begin to ask, where is this passion going to take us? There are many ways to answer this question. Some of us bring our passions to colleges, careers, or into various parts of our community. When we branch out, we meet new people who have the same passion, and relationships can be built from there. Whether your passion is in healthcare, music, or welding, The key to finding joy is to pursue what you love. After we pursue our passions, we begin to extend our flame and inspire other people. Those that we inspire could be our family, friends, or loved ones. Our passions warm the people around us and sometimes stir the ashes to become a new flame. Remember, graduates, life is short. There are many hurdles in the future, but keeping your passions alive will make the journey more meaningful. There is something out there for everyone to be passionate about, and all it takes is just one spark to turn into a flame.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Delana Martin, Student Council Vice President. Dear Class of 2023, teachers, parents, administration, and friends, I'm grateful to stand before you today. Throughout these beautiful years of life that I was blessed to spend with you all, we were always taught to shoot for the moon. From the early age of kindergarten, Greeneville City Schools has pushed us to be the best human beings possible. As you look to your left and to your right, you will see your fellow classmates with whom you started out learning basic skills of life with. 13 years later, and you are about to receive your diploma with those same friends. Our attempts at shooting for the moon have developed us into the amazing young adults that we are. Beginning in third grade, we started learning about the moon and its phases. Just as the moon changes constantly, we went through phases as well. Some of us went through the braces phase, the video game phase, or the not talking to our parents phase. But overall, these phases shaped us into the people that we are. Each phase in our life made us stronger as we weathered it, until another phase in our life was revealed. Our many phases have taught us to trust in our fate and wait on opportunities to arise. We must have courage to face a new day every day. Every day is a new chance to grow and seek new opportunities. We must also learn to be positive amongst negativity. The moon can only shine to its full potential in a completely dark sky. When difficult times arise, we have to be courageous in the face of adversity. The goal is to learn how to thrive, even among the setbacks in our lives. We must stay bold and persevere through challenges, because just as the moon hides itself from us, it is brave enough to reveal itself once again. As we travel to new places, I hope we're all reminded that our family and friends are always with us, because just like the moon, even when you can't see it, it is always there, just like those who love us. The lessons and morals that they have taught us remain even when we are separated. No matter where we are in the world, the moon can always be found overhead. Our family and friends will always be cherished in our hearts despite the distance between us. We all have those people in our lives that radiate positivity and light. Like the moon, it is necessary to draw from whatever light source we can. The moon does not produce its own light, it reflects the sunlight. We cannot achieve success without those around us. We have learned to use others' light to shine. I hope that you spread your light and are the light source for those around you. As we graduate and ponder on all of the memories we have made throughout our years, I hope we remember how we grew. We grew as students, as friends, in our faith, and as people. Like the moon, we will never know how much we have truly grown until we reach our full potential. I assure you, class of 2023, we have not yet reached our full potential. There are so many accomplishments that we have not yet achieved, people we have not met, and places we have not yet traveled. I hope you all fulfill all of your dreams and ambitions. Like the moon, people look up to us. We are the example for younger students and our younger siblings. We owe it to ourselves to make them proud. Starting today, our lunch jumpers will be recycled to the new kindergarten class. We owe it to that kindergartner to achieve all that we are able to in life, because they look up to us like the moon. As we part our separate ways, I hope we are all reminded that whether we are in different states or traveling abroad, we can be comforted in knowing that we are all living under the same moon. We are all going through phases and trying to soak up as much light as possible so we can eventually reflect it back to others. Greeneville City Schools has prepared us for this new life that is ahead. And to my fellow graduates, we were always taught to shoot for the moon, but today, my friends, we have landed among the stars.
Thank you. Graduates, my name is Jackson Bedingfield. Shakespeare once wrote, "All the world is a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances." 4 years ago, the class of 2023 made their entrance to Greeneville High School, and in doing so, faced a plethora of challenges along the way. From the total impact that the recent pandemic has had on our everyday learning, to the tragic loss of two of our own GHS students. We have faced a great deal of hardship over these past 4 years. However, along with those challenges, our class has also accomplished many notable feats during our time at GHS. We survived algebra, world history, biology. Individuals from our GHS chorus auditioned for and performed in the Tennessee All-State Choir. We saw members of our own Pride of the Devils band invited to New York City to march in the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. We continue to live up to being Title Town through the numerous state championships that our athletes have taken part in. While I'm not much of an athlete myself, I was able to find my place in theater at a young age. Recently at GHS, we have showcased our first few productions of our new theater program. All the world's a stage. That metaphor has always fascinated me during my many years of community theater. One thing being on stage has taught me is the value of resilience, the capacity to withstand or to recover quickly from difficulties. In theater, there is risk. Everything is performed live without the aid of a post-production editing process like modern cinema. Anything could go wrong in the middle of a performance. Just ask Cooper Graham, who only a few weeks ago had a set piece collapse beneath him on stage. How you respond to those unexpected events will either make or break the story. The same is true in life. Though the unexpected is inevitable, what you choose in the moments after has the power to change the course of your story. Choose to make your story even better than it ever could have been before. Allow those disappointments to build your character and make you a person people can aspire to. Resilience can help you not only as an actor, but as you journey through the ages of your life. Another lesson my time in theater has taught me is the value of surrounding yourself with people who will support you from the wings. The wings of a stage are the areas to each side, masked off by large curtains, just out the view from the audience. When I was 7, I auditioned for my very first play. During that audition, I was asked to convey an emotion. I chose anger. I can remember that after conveying that emotion, Miss Marilyn DeBrisk, our director, responded with a shocked, "Whoa, I believe you." She spent the next decade of my life pouring into me as an actor and as a person. While I was on the stage, Miss Marilyn stood in the wings, supporting and encouraging me, invisible to the audience. However, she was the support I needed when I took the stage. I'm willing to bet that each of you have a Miss Marilyn or two in your lives. Just look around you. We are surrounded by people who have poured into us throughout the course of our lives. These parents, these family members, these coaches, these teachers, these friends have had a profound role in the building of our characters. From the wings, their love and encouragement give us the courage to take risks, dream big, and have resilience. Finally, through theater, I have learned to trust the director. The director has a unique vantage point to being able to see not only the distinct qualities that you bring to your character, but also the direction of where the story is going, the finished product, the big picture. In life, our director has created us each with gifts and qualities that are set apart and allow us to play our roles in life. He is not surprised by those unexpected events, but he shows us how to use and learn from those instances throughout the rest of our time on Earth. Trust the director to show you your way through your story. So now, my fellow players, our entrance is passed, and now we make our exit from Greeneville High School. I challenge you to be resilient, to hold fast to the people who will support you from the wings, and to trust the director as we step out onto a new stage and transition into the next scenes of our stories.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Maggie Hartman, and I am pleased to welcome the friends and family of the class of 2023, along with all of the others who helped us get here. I'm incredibly honored to be a graduation speaker, but I must admit that writing this speech was a bit more difficult than I had imagined. It was even harder than Algebra 2 during sophomore year, and I didn't think there was anything much harder than that. So now I need to make you laugh, then cry, then inspire you, and make it short. So as you can see, I have a lot to accomplish these next few minutes, but I'll try. But before I accomplish any of these things, let's all take one last selfie together. Okay, that'll be on my Instagram or more than likely my mom's Facebook later for everybody to steal. We grew up with the number 2023 engraved in our minds, a reminder of our possibilities and a countdown to the rest of our lives. We said, "That's so far away, I can't wait to grow up." Now we have grown up, and we have new adult choices to make. Now we are 17 and 18, wishing that we hadn't wished our time away, wishing that our biggest worry was a spelling test on Friday instead of what we were going to do with the rest of our lives. As I'm standing here before you, I can't help but think about how we got here. When we were just babies, we all fell when we tried to learn how to walk. When we were a little bit older, we started trying to ride bikes. And I can't speak for everyone, but I know I had quite a few scraped knees before I ever got the hang of it. Then, when we started school in kindergarten and tried to tie our shoes for the first time, there were quite a few knots that my mom had to untangle after school. Needless to say, first steps are never easy. Now we have many big choices and challenges about the rest of our lives. Where will we go? Who will we date? What job will we have? Will we be our own boss, or will we work for someone? Will we stay here in Greeneville, or will we move to California? It feels like all of these choices are going to be for the rest of our lives. But we can change our minds, and probably will, especially if we fail in some of these decisions. We have failed before, even in high school. Although we may have studied, we may still have failed the test. We may have practiced for hours, but may not have made the team or won the game. Ultimately, we shouldn't be afraid to fail. Thomas Edison failed over 1,000 times before ever coming up with the first successful light bulb model. Walt Disney, Elvis Presley, and even Michael Jordan were considered failures too. Walt Disney had a newspaper editor claim that he had no imagination or good ideas. The King of Rock and Roll was told that he wasn't going anywhere and to go back to driving a truck.
Michael Jordan was cut from his high school basketball team. The widely known author of Harry Potter, J.K. Rowling, once said, "Failure meant stripping away the inessential." This can apply to anyone in any aspect of life. Failing means finding out what needs to change in order to be successful. By failing, we learn that not everything comes easy in life. We learn to try again and try harder until we make it. It creates a mindset that allows us to prevail through adversities and challenges. Winston Churchill said, "Success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts." When half of us failed our permit test the first time, that didn't keep us from retaking it. Although maybe it should have, because some of us still shouldn't be on the road considering the driving skills seen in the back parking lot. Or when my friends and I failed one, or many, of our AP US history tests, we kept studying, and then we changed the way we studied. We adapted to what that class required from us. Even though at the end of it, we may not have received the AP score that we strive for, it's okay. It is okay to accept that you aren't good at everything, and it is perfectly normal for your strengths and weaknesses to be revealed. That does not mean to give up, and it certainly does not mean that your failure is final. Embracing failure does not mean that you must stop there. Your emotions, your mentality, and you change from failure. Naturally, most people are going to experience intense emotions when they fail, whether that be sadness, anger, or defeat. Regardless, that is never a reason to stop trying. Failure is defined as the lack of success, not the impossibility of it, meaning that you should not give up as we leave from here and go discover new things. Failure does not have to break you, it should build you. Today, we are leaving the place that watched us fail countless times, watched us succeed, but most importantly, watched us grow. So remember to embrace your failures and use them for your success. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Yeah.
thank you. You did a phenomenal job with your speeches and performances. I would like to begin by thanking all students, parents, friends, and family members who are in attendance for the joyous celebration of the class of 2023. As our graduates proceed into the next chapter of their lives, I hope they are aware of how extremely proud we are. We are proud of the grit, the determination that they have embodied every day that they've walked through the doors of Greeneville High School. We are proud of the countless scholarships and opportunities that this group of seniors have accumulated. In fact, we could spend hours listing the accomplishments of this senior class, but I would rather highlight how proud we are of their grit, perseverance, and how the obstacles that they've overcome. Parents, let's reflect for a moment about your senior's childhood. Failure can be defined as the lack of success or the omission of expected required action. Success has been expected of this class since they were toddlers. From learning to walk to saying their first words, expectations have played a role in their growth. Do you remember waiting on them to say their first words and worrying that other children of the same age reached a milestone before your child? From a young age, we have held our students to extremely high expectations. We have learned that when a student falls short of an expectation, it is about the journey and the people that help the student improve and perform up to their own unique standards. Because although Einstein didn't speak in a full sentence until age 5, he still is acknowledged as one of the most influential physicists of all time. In fact, a quote from Einstein states, "Failure is success in progress." It is vital to remember that failure to meet expectations is simply a tool to learn to persevere to meet an end goal. I hope that we remind our students that failure is often followed by success if coupled with perseverance. To the parents and family members present here today, it is with the utmost respect that I tell you how much you are valued and appreciated. The good character that has been displayed by your graduates is rooted in good families and home lives. From the early age of kindergarten, you have prepared your student to achieve success in Greenville City Schools. At home, the idea of preparation changed as they grew. We started out dropping our children off in elementary school with their lunchbox and their blanket for rest time. We encouraged them to make friends and memorize their phone number in case they ever needed us. I remember watching my daughter light up when she was able to read her first Curious George book. We now watch our kids light up as they are about to receive their high school diploma. We have devoted our time to preparing our students to face the world. But now they are preparing us as they leave and chase their biggest dream. No longer are we consoling them as they face their first day of kindergarten, but time has flown and they are consoling us as they have faced their very last day as a Green Devil here at Greeneville High School. From the teachers and staff at Greeneville High School, parents, we honor you and we appreciate you. To the graduates, I know you have learned many life lessons. You have faced and overcome challenges in Greeneville City Schools. Above all, I hope you are reminded of the mountains and valleys. To begin, let's start with the lows. The different lows that we have faced have lasted from days to months. 2020 was the longest valley that we have faced in the 4 years you've been at Greeneville High School. By April of 2020, about half of the world's population was under lockdown. It was emotionally draining to not be with our family and friends and able to interact with our friends, teachers, and families. We didn't recognize it at the time, but we are now aware of just how extremely low that valley was. There will always be valleys among the paths that we have chosen to walk. Most of the time, we don't know how deep the valley is until we are on top of the mountain. I hope you find comfort in knowing that there is hope after experiencing the lows that life throws at us. We must walk through the valleys with strength and dignity, keeping your head held high. If you walk through the valleys with your head down, you may never see the mountain that's right ahead of you. May you remember that weathering the storms that you faced in the valley is always easier when you have friends to hold you steady. Hold tight to the bonds and relationships that you have created here at Greeneville High School and at Greeneville City Schools, because storms among our journey are inevitable. Once you are clear of the valleys, it is time to start climbing that mountain. You may not be able to see the very top or know where the final destination is. Stay true to your character and use the grit that you have demonstrated to continue the battle to the top. When you reach the top, you will be able to look out and feel accomplished because you will see all the obstacles that you have crossed. Our problems are often not as big as we make them seem. I hope that you stay humble, because when you are on the top of the mountain and look out, people seem much smaller as well. Stay humble and thank the people that weathered the storm with you. We can be reminded of this by former professional basketball player Ray Allen. Allen quotes, "Everything I know now, the pitfalls, the highs, the lows, everything, it taught me and it made me stronger." Always remember that you have a family in Greeneville City Schools. Today, Greeneville High School graduates Eastview Elementary School students, Howe-Hennard Elementary students, Highland Elementary students, Tusculum-View Elementary students, TOPS students, Greeneville Middle School students, and GTC students. At this time, I would like for every Greeneville City School educator, which includes bus drivers, custodial, maintenance, nurses, cafeteria, teachers, assistants, and administrative staff, to pat yourself on the back because you helped these students. Thank you to these educators. Remember, you don't have to face the mountains and valleys alone. Your Greeneville City School family of educators are here for you always. As you begin a new life, we will be first to congratulate you for your accomplishments. You have countless cheerleaders that will be cheering you on as we watch you stand tall on the mountain peaks. I hope you are always reminded that you will always have a support system when you are facing the valleys. The relationships that you have built during your school career will last for a lifetime. Today, we are awarding 250 diplomas. We are also honoring one foreign exchange student and one honorary graduate. The class of 2023 has 90 honor scholars. If you are an honor scholar, would you please stand to be recognized? Thank you. There are 60 community service scholars. Would you stand to be recognized? There are 96 State of Tennessee graduates of distinction. Would you please stand to be recognized? There are 78 Tennessee graduates with honors. Would you stand to be recognized? There are 7 students recognized for a work ethic distinction. Would you please stand to be recognized? Thank you. There are 158 Tennessee Hope eligible students. Would you please stand? There are 187 Tennessee Promise eligible students. Would you please stand to be recognized? There are 61 TriStar scholars that is signified by a pen. Would you please stand to be recognized? Thank you. GHS will have 4 students leaving us to serve in our national military service. Would you please stand to be recognized? Greeneville High School students earned 186 industry certifications. If you earned one of those, would you please stand to be recognized? Thank you. Greeneville High School class of 2023 will be taking with them 930 college credits to colleges and universities across the nation. Finally, I am proud to announce that Greeneville High School class of 2023 earned total in scholarship money $6,646,879 of scholarship money. During 4 years at Greeneville High School, you've obtained 30 conference championships in various sports. Over the 4 years, you've had 11 regional championships, 20 regional runner-up awards, 20 individual state championships in track and wrestling, 1 runner-up state championship for our 2023 soccer team, and finally, 6 TSSAA state championships, including our 2023 TSSAA baseball champions. If you were a member of any of these teams, please stand. Students have qualified for the All East Honor Choir 54 times in their 4 years at Greeneville High School and qualified for All State Honor Choir 33 times. 10 ensembles from GHS received superior ratings, with 5 of those earning perfect scores. At the State Choral Performance Assessment, 3 ensembles received superior ratings, ranking them among the best in the state of Tennessee. Pride of the Devil Band earned 6 first place marching band awards, 9 marching band superiors, numerous first and second place finishes with our Winter Guard and Indoor Drumline, 4 Bandmaster Sweepstakes awards, and 3 Concert Performance Assessment superiors. If you received any of those awards, if you participated, please stand. You may be seated. Remember that this new life ahead may involve some valleys, but we have to go through them to succeed. When you stumble along your journey, pick yourself up and continue to climb that mountain until you reach the top. We are so proud of you. Your parents, the Greeneville City School staff, and the community will always be here to lend a helping hand and cheer you through the highs and lows. I would like to thank you for allowing me to be such a small part of the journey that you are on. You have made an unbelievable impact on your community. It was a blessing to be your principal. I can't wait to see you on the peaks of the mountains. And always remember, Miss Martin loves you.
Ms. Martin, thank you. Good morning. Welcome, students, parents, honored guests, faculty, staff, and administrators. We're so glad you're here to share in this joyous occasion. Before I begin, I would like to take a minute to recognize the Greeneville City Board of Education, our board chair, Ms. Cindy Luttrell, vice chair, Dr. Craig Shepherd, treasurer, Mr. Josh Quillen, board member, Mrs. Pam Botta, board member, Mrs. Crystal Hershey, and student member, Mr. Asher Rogers. presence of the members of the board demonstrates their commitment to education and the pride they have in our students and their many accomplishments. I also want to recognize all GCS educators. Please stand at this time to be recognized if you are a GCS educator. Ms. Martin has already detailed who that is. If you'll please stand at this time. Thank you. 2 years ago, a group of Greeneville City Schools students, including students in this graduating class, parents, teachers, community and business leaders, administrators, and central office personnel worked together to develop the Greeneville City Schools Portrait of a Graduate. In the Portrait of a Graduate, we worked to identify six characteristics that we wanted every graduate from Greeneville High School to possess. The traits identified were to be a personally responsible citizen, an innovator, an effective communicator, a critical thinker, to show empathy, and to be resilient. What does it mean to be a personally responsible citizen? I think former President John F. Kennedy summed it up very well when he said, "Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country." We want each of our graduates to thoughtfully engage in civic activities, acting with honesty, integrity, and demonstrating care for the larger community and greater good. An innovative Greeneville High School graduate demonstrates adaptability, flexibility, and agility in thoughts and action. They take what is and make it better. An ancient Chinese proverb states, "When the winds of change blow, some people build walls and others build windmills." Let's always strive to build windmills. A graduate from GHS has the foundational skills to be able to effectively communicate and articulate thoughts and ideas effectively using oral, written, and nonverbal communication. Skills in a variety of forms and contexts. However, one of the most overlooked attributes of good communication is one's ability to listen. Stephen M. R. Covey sums it up this way: "Seek first to understand, then to be understood." It simply means listen before you talk. We are confident that Greeneville High School graduates are now on track to be lifelong critical thinkers and will consistently strive to improve the quality of their thinking by skillfully analyzing, assessing, and reconstructing thoughts in a manner that is clear, rational, and informed by evidence. Albert Einstein stated, "We can't solve problems by using the same kind of thinking we used when we created them." Alfred Adler, Austrian medical doctor and psychotherapist, stated, "Empathy is seeing with the eyes of another, listening with the ears of another, and feeling with the heart of another." Students are prepared throughout their time within Greeneville City Schools to be empathetic and consider the thoughts, feelings, and experiences of others with compassion. The world can always use a little bit more kindness. The final characteristic that we believe each of you is leaving GHS with is resilience. A person who is resilient exhibits steadfastness in achieving success despite difficulty, opposition, and or failure. Roger Crawford, recognized by Sports Illustrated as one of the most accomplished physically challenged athletes in history, beautifully summed up resilience this way: "Being challenged in life is inevitable. Being defeated is optional." Vision for Greeneville City Schools is that our graduates will be prepared and confident to own their future. Through the attainment of the characteristics identified in our GCS Portrait of a Graduate, we believe each graduate will be able to realize that vision. GHS Class of 2023, your teachers, administrators, coaches, extracurricular sponsors, and other school staff members have done everything within their power to provide you with a world-class education and to ensure that you are future ready. You have honored them by the level of success you have achieved. Be confident in and believe in this preparation and use it to achieve your dreams and fulfill your destiny. Author John Maxwell states, "The only true freedom each of us has in life is the freedom to choose. The most important choice is who we will become. We cannot wait to learn who you will become and the achievements you will accomplish. Ms. Martin, I am pleased to accept this graduating class. On behalf of the town of Greeneville, the Board of Education, the administration, teachers, and staff of all Greeneville City Schools, and by the power vested in me by the state of Tennessee, I hereby declare you graduates of the Greeneville City School System. Congratulations and Godspeed. And go Devils."
Before we recognize the class of 2023 that sits before us, we want to take a moment to honor students of the 2023 class that are not here with us today, but that are always in our hearts. At this time, we invite a family member to come forward representing Daniel Owens and Tegan Welch to the stage. Daniel Owens graduated earlier in the school year. We would like her grandfather to receive her diploma at this time. Tegan Welch is earning an honorary diploma from Greeneville City Schools and Greeneville High School. We invite her mother to receive her diploma at this time.
Danielle Rayanne Owen.
Tegan Karen Welch.
Eden Ruth Aiken. Aiden Thomas Alter. Jeremiah Aureliano Hernandez. Lillian Christine Armstrong. William James Armstrong. Jaquela Marie Arietta. Wyatt Nathaniel Baggett. Lauren Elizabeth Bailey. Angelique Nicole Barner. Devin Raylee Barner. Sydney Hope Batson. Olivia Marie Gwendolyn Battle.
Jackson Brooks Bedingfield.
Anna Kathleen Benson. Yareli Monserath Bernal. Devin Nathaniel Barrier. Bryson Jeffrey Bird. Jada Rose Black. Tana Bree Bookhammer. Madeline Gail Bowman. Isaac Andrew Wayne Bradford. Ella Lauren Braun. Reagan McKenna Aishao Bride. Tyler Ray Brenniger. Anakin Lyle James Brooks. And Marie Cordelia Brown. Emily Lizeth Brown. Alexander Davis Broyles. Alexander Jason Bergduff. Nasheer Bareem Burks. Marley Rose Burns. Cole Riley Burton. Cora Lindy Carter. John Wayne Carter Jr. Brennan Riley Casebeer. Andy Castillo Meza. Josue Imanol Castillo Ramirez. Gerardo Castillo Ruiz. Abigail Joe Lee Chestnut. Anderson Otoniel Caban Lopez. Cody Aaron Hensley Colston. Cohen Philip Creech. Ajante Jabron Dabbs. Congrats. Gabriel Nicholas DeLibro. Mackenzie Rose DeRocker. Chase Austin Dixon. William Scott Dixon. Miley Grace Doty. Lauren Riley Doyle. Colin Hunter Dupil. Jalen James Durbin.
Tamarin Malin Ellenberg. Aiden Michael Ellington. Chloe Sandra Etherton. Lindsay Randy Evans. Christian Diego Alexander Feltner. Caden Lee Fillers. Elizabeth Jana Fellers. Dakota Lee Fisher. William Tanner Fisher. Ansley Hope Ford. Gabriel Cole Fowler. Aiden Drake Galloway. Jacob Todd Giddings. Nicholas Gomez Zebelugu. Catherine Gonzalez Martinez. Cameron Charles Goods. It's right there. Keep going. Be smart. Cooper William Graham. Justin Paul Gray. Maya Bliss Grukunas. Jonah Cage Griffin. Marley Francis Gross. Timothy Stephen Galino.
John Albert Hankins.
Adia Destiny Leanne Heron. Jacob Hunter Harmon. Allison Marie Harris. Avery Matei White Harris. Alex Timothy Hartman. Maggie Faith Hartman. Molly Grace Hartman. Andrew Wyatt Hay. Zachary Jude Hayes. Zoe Grace Hayes. Noah Andrew Hilton. Landon Seth Hensley. Taliana Herlinda Hernandez. Kevin D. Jesus Hernandez Corzo. Luke Ulrich Harrell. Russell Scott Hickey. Drew Alexander Hillier. Susanna Gail Holt. Trevor Shane Hobson. Tyler Gregory Hobson. Justin Eugene Howes. Michaela Faye Huberts. Savannah Lee Hudnell. Donquez DeLeon Huff. Joshua Alexander Hyde. Reagan Marie Johnson. Richard Gage Johnson. Allison Nicole Jones. Chandler James Keeling.
Braden Eric Kennedy. Holly Marie Kinney. Gavin Matthew Keena. Emily Rose King. Sutton Philip Kirkpatrick.
Anne Marie Kinesny. John Andrew Kinesny.
Abby Danielle Lane. Aiden Joseph Laughlin. John Nolan Lawler. Mason Lance Alexander Laws. Christopher Ryan Lawson. Morgan Lynn Leach. Angel Danielle Lee. Catherine Grace LaFue. Paisley LaFay Lawler. Hannah Roberta Loretz Mejia. Leanne Mara Lowe. Natalie Catherine Lowe. Morgan Brannon Delano Lowry. Ella Kyrie Maddox. Caitlin Celia Rose Marion. Chloe Elizabeth Marsh.
Delana Grace Martin.
Christian Heriberto Martinez. Hunter Michael Mason. Harley Dawn Massey. Christian Julian McBride. William Andrew McCamey. Braden Reuben McCaslin. Patience Sienna McDade. Maddox Thomas McKinney. Julian Brooke McQuaid. Jaden Tyann Merriweather. Madison Faith Metcalf. Cameron Elizabeth Miles. Madison Grace Miller. Trey Bradford Miller. Mario LaRon Mincy. Megan Nicole Morlock. Tristan Clarence Morlock. Caden Benjamin Morgan. Zachary Stephen Milo Neeson. Connor Allen Noonan. Bladen Shields Norton. Cicely Mary Oakley. Emma Elizabeth Olson. Dawson Bradford Odinger. Aaron Charles Owens. Alicia Danielle Pace. Kendall Wade Parton. Gia Jignasukumar Patel. Jose Luis Pereira.
Gavin Dale Pickard. Connor Dean Pickering. Carla Natalie Pina. Jaquan Jerome Price.
Lily Ann Probst.
Brady Jackson Eugene Quillen. Alice Allison Gabrielle Ra. Adrian Ramos Martinez. Jasmine Rayo Gregorio. Yoselin Yesenia Rayon Cedillo. Allie Elizabeth Renner. Isabel Audrey Reyes. Bianca Marie Ricker. Emma Grace Ricker. Katie Sue Reitinger. Alyssa Danielle Roberts. Michaela Cheyenne Robinson. Spencer Kenneth Robinson. Asher Elijah Rogers. Kevin Rayel Ruiz. Eleanor Ann Sayer. Sheldon Theodore Sams. Caroline Margaret Blanche Sossman. Caleb Vaughn Shackey.
Mason James Scheffler.
Faith Marilyn Schubert. Cheyenne Janelle Sellers.
Allison Faith Shelton.
Andrew Glenn Shelton. Michael Nathan Shetley. Braxton Levi Wayne Shipley. Parker John Shipley. Laura Emsley Shiree. Jalen Edward Short. Damian Eric Short II. Jennifer Anel Simmons. Ashton Colby Smith. Faith Leanna Smith. Olivia Danielle Smith. Malaysia Riandre Nicole Smith Morong. Bianca Elise Sneed. Jonathan Ray Sneed. Caden Suzanne Sprawls. Patrick Roy Stanton. Ethan Andrew Sutherland. Marcus Evan Sweat. Marissa Nicole Taylor. William Colton Tenney. Richard David Thompson. Oh, yeah, Ricky. Ty Cooper Thompson. Levi Graham Tipton. Martin Torres Camacho. Abby Nicole Trantham.
Lillian Chloe Treadway. Caden Lane Treble. Elliot Michael Tucker. Ronald Velasquez. Alex Vertiz Ramos. Alessandra Yulitza Vicente Lopez. Luna Melissa Vigil. Alden Conrad Wakefield. Joshua Michael Wallace. Aubrey Pauline Weems. Emerald Crystal Weflin. Marianne Ruth Whaley. Faith Alexandria Wheeler. Landon Joseph White. Libby Palmer Whitehouse. Austin Michael Whitson. Madison Faith Wilkerson. Amelia J. Williams. Caitlin Bray Williams. Shyla Emily Williams. Ty Allen Williams. Chloe Grace Williford. Landon Scott Willis. Elena Nicole Winter. Nicholas Peter Wright. Caleb Allen Wyke.
Upon please rise. Please stand and remain in your seats until the singing of the alma mater and the recessional of the graduates. Graduates have been instructed to go outside of the stadium to meet family and friends. You may meet your graduates outside the stadium concluding the recessional. Members of the class of 2023, you began the ceremony tonight as members of the GHS graduating class. With the awarding of your diplomas, you may now stand and transfer your tassels. Now you are a member of the GHS alumni class of 2023. Graduates, under your seat you will find a cowbell to ring once the alma mater has been sang when you are tossing your cap. As a reminder, the Kiker cannon will sound as the graduates are tossing their caps. Please join us in singing the Greeneville High School alma mater at this time.